Good morning, students. Today we learn the basic Hadoop administration process. What are the two main areas of administration process in Hadoop? Means one is in a YARN resource manager and the HDFS file system. The others may be like a MapReduce framework and other tools are having their own set of management files, except the YARN resource manager and the HDFS file system. So Hadoop configuration is accomplished through the use of XML configuration files, that is an extended markup language file. So there are some of the main basic files and their functions we have to know before the configuration. One is called as a core default XML. XML, that is a system wide properties, and HDFS default XML, that is a Hadoop distribution distributed file system. Then map Red default XML, that is the properties of the YARN MapReduce framework, and the YARN default XML, that is about the YARN properties. So here I want to conclude, there are some system wide properties, there is a HDFS properties, there is a MapReduce framework, and the YARN properties in terms of an XML file. That is the basics and the functions of the XML files. Now this is the path. YARN has several built-in administrative features and commands. To find out more, then we have to know about the YARN commands documentation with this path. Now decommissioning YARN nodes. For example, if a node manager host or a nodes need to be removed from the cluster, it should be first decommissioned. So decommissioning is nothing but to remove it from the nodes, or it is the nodes are removed from the cluster. Assuming the node is responding, you can easily decommission it from the Ambari web user interface. Simply go to the host view, click on the host and select decommission from the pull down menu next to the node manager. This is not just nothing but a removing in the bridges. Now basic Hadoop administration process, that is a YARN web proxy. It is in a proxy, separate proxy server in YARN that addresses the security issues with respect to the cluster web services. And by default, proxy runs as a part of the resource manager itself, but it can be deconfigured. It can be configured to run in a standalone mode by adding the configuration property YARN, that is web proxy address to YARN site XML. Next, using the job history server, the removal of the job tracker and the migration of the MapReduce from a system to an application level framework is nothing but a job history server. So the previous history, what all the tracks of the job or the migrations from the MapReduce framework, is nothing but the job history server. Job history server provides all YARN MapReduce application with a central location in which to aggregate completed jobs for historical reference and debugging. So this is nothing but found in the MapRed site XML, that is a history job track files. Next is YARN jobs. Now YARN jobs can be managed using any YARN application command. The following options include kill, list, status are available to the administrator with this command. MapReduce job can also be controlled within a MapRed job commands. So that is nothing but application ID. You remember in the previous class it is MapRed site.xml, also an option application ID to remove the files. Next is a setting container memory, that is about the YARN node manager resource memory, YARN scheduler minimum allocation and scheduler maximum, that is about 8192 MB, and these are some of the memory containers and the allocation in the administration. Similarly, container cores, that is of the scheduler minimum, maximum and about the resources. Similarly, the setting of the MapReduce property. My dear students, this is one of the important topic. You must know what all the properties of MapReduce and what all the scheduling and settings can be changed. One is called MapRed child Java, MapRed memory, then MapRed reduce memory, MapRed reduce Java option. These are the five tools you must remember in the property. The one is called as YARN application. The in that map, you can see here MapRed site XLNL property. This is one. Second is child. Third is memory. Reduce memory, reduce Java. So this is about the five yarn application settings we are going to change. Next is about the basic administration. So basic HDFS administration is name node. With that we already studied from the module 1. What is the name node? How to interface the name node? That is monitoring the HDFS. And then there are five tabs on user interface. That is overview, data node, snapshot, startup, progress and utilities. So this is about the five user interface we must know. One is overview. Overview provides the much of the essential information. Data node to display the node information. Snapshot gives about the snapshotable directories. Then progress gives about the process compilation with respect to time. Utility, two options. One is file system browser, whereas another one is an HDFS namespace, that is nothing but the name node logs. So these are the five informations about the properties or the nodes of the user interface in with respect to the name node. So we will learn now what all we studied about the YARN administration and about the basic HDFS administration in the execution. So when we compile the Hadoop, here we can see when we install it, we'll get an Hadoop overview, data node, snapshot, start, progress and utilities. So these are the five properties of user interface. That is, one name node can interact with another name node. This is about the name node user interface. So here we studied about the overview. You can see the slide, data node, snapshot, start, progress and utilities. So what is data node? Data node contains the name of the node, admin status, what is the capacity used and number of options used, and then about the decommissioning, that is nothing but removing. I can remove, that is name node web interfaces shows the status of number of data nodes. So here we can see that is about the Ambari applications and name node information, that is about the snapshot. Next is startup progress. Startup progress is also in loading the images, so that is about the loading, editing, saving and save mode. These are the four operations: save the mode, saving the checkpoints, loading edits and about loading the images. That is about delegation tokens, or it may be inodes or a cache pools or etc. So this is about the implementation or the progress with respect to time. Then browsing history, as we know it already, this talks about the browsing utility. Browsing utility directory is just talking about the utility. Next we'll move on to the adding the users to an HDFS. So how we can add, so this is called as a group name and username, and how to add group name and username. So this is about the information to check the health of HDFS. You can issue an HDFS fsck file system check command, fsck command. So perform an file check on HDFS. So these are the options. You can see there are examples to check the HDFS. One is file check is move, delete file, open for write, list correct file blocks, blocks and location. What is memory blocks? Prints out a block report. Corrupt file blocks prints out a list of missing blocks. Similarly, you can see the status of a healthy, as we discussed in the previous class. If you want to check the health of the HDFS, you must know about the options, and these are the example of the file health check. Okay, file check commands: total size, total directories, number of files, system link, what is a block. Block is nothing but the missed files. That is your missed files. Block is nothing but print out a block reports or print out a list of missing blocks. So you can find your total blocks and minimally replicated blocks, over replicated blocks, default replication factors and corrupt blocks is zero. Missing replicas is zero. Number of data nodes. This is about the file check commands. Now we've got the balancing of HDFS can be done with the data node availability, number of data blocks across the data nodes. To avoid overutilization data nodes, balance tool rebalance the data blocks across the available, that is about